Hey, how's it going? My name's Alex, and I asked you in a previous video, what kind of videos do you want to see? And you guys overwhelmingly said vlogs. So here is your vlog. Now, time lapses are fun, but let me tell you what's going on here so you can have a little bit of context. This load I picked up in Lewisville, Texas, it's going to Sioux Falls, South Dakota. This is actually one of the largest pork processing plants. And you know, like a couple months ago when there was all this coronavirus stuff going around like crazy, it's even worse now by case count, but back then there was a bunch of problems at the meat packing plants, and there was this scare of national shortage of meats. So this plant was shut down, but now what they're doing, the reason there's some construction is because they are building more offices, or not offices, they're building more break rooms that are so people can social distance on while they're on break. And so this load was going from Lewisville, Texas to Sioux Falls, South Dakota for $1,500. You can see it was about 2,000 pounds. I'm like the government with redacting everything. So it was $1,500. If you're wondering how much that is, it's roughly 800 miles right here. So you can see Lewisville, that's like DFW area. Sioux Falls, obviously we know that is, but that's not the only thing I have on my trailer. As you can see, I do have those platforms.
Well, good morning. Welcome back to the vlog. Guys, today we are in the Dakotas. So as you saw, honestly, I love it when a plan comes together. I love it when things go really smoothly. The phone number on the bill of lading was 100% correct. I called the guy, he's like, I'll be there in 5-10 minutes. And sure enough, he came and grabbed me. And as you guys just saw, I did unload the, I believe it was the foam insulation panels, that's what those were. And so I just dropped those off. That was really, really nice. I picked all this stuff up. I picked it all up Friday. So really, really easy pickup, delivery. I mean, just a fantastic weekend. Just a quick check before I take off of all my straps and whatnot. And then we are gonna go to North Dakota. It's chilly, it's cool, but barely any snow. I haven't seen any crazy, nothing out of the ordinary for this time of year, I guess. So anyways, everything looks good. Let's hit the road. All right, just wanna give you a quick update that the dispatcher ended up booking me a load. I don't know how, but I believe it's somewhere in North Dakota or something like that, or it's like at the bottom. I'm going to Tioga, North Dakota, and he booked me a load from, maybe it's like right by the border of South Dakota. It's a small town that I already, pulled over. Oh, Colm, South Dakota, I believe it is. That's where we're going. Fun times. And he said, or no, Colm, North Dakota. My apologies. Wow, Alex, learn geography. There's just so many small towns in North Dakota and South Dakota that it's like, but anyway, so we're taking a quick detour. It looks like I'll be there, by the end of the day today. So I'll be able to go pick up today. And then my drop in North Dakota is only 8 hours away from me total. So in reality, I'll be there first thing tomorrow morning to deliver this load. So anyways, let's just crank out these miles, get them done, and go pick up this load. I was not expecting this, so that's great. Now this right here is the perfect example of how a dispatcher works versus how an owner operator would possibly load himself, right? So for example, I wouldn't look for a load until I got unloaded in Tioga, North Dakota. Now he decided to, hey, you're unloaded now, you're driving on the way up and you have the deck space for it. And he booked me this load right here. Let me show you right here. So it's the Colm, North Dakota to McGee, Arkansas. So it's $1,625 on the loaded mile, or dollars on the loaded miles. And so here it is, I routed it out. It's like 1162 on the miles roughly. So overall it's not like, it's not bad, especially how small it is. You know what I mean? You go figure like about $1.40, $1.50, it probably comes out on that small plow, right? So it's not bad at all. Now that load to Tioga, North Dakota though, here it is. It's Rome, Texas to Tioga, North Dakota. I believe I'm saying that correctly. And it was $2,500. So if you figure that the other load is paying $1,500 and this one's $25, that's 4,000
$1,000 I picked up, I picked up Friday and I was empty Tuesday morning, right? Well, I wasn't empty. I had that plow going to Arkansas, but you could say $4,000 basically Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, I'm empty Tuesday morning. So really, really, that's a solid weekend. And, and then if you figure that one was paying $1,600, that wasn't the only thing I took because I have more loads coming up. But if you figure $1,600, if I just went with that, that would be $5,600 in less than a week. So really, really not bad, going to North Dakota. The only thing is the more snow they get, the colder it becomes, the worse, the more likely you are to get stuck and the worse it is to take freight up there.
All right, super cool. Loaded just like that, pretty easy. They chained it up for me too, obviously, because they probably don't want people damaging it. But the last thing is we got to go inside the office door right there. and then we're gonna get that paperwork and then we can keep going further north in North Dakota.
So I delivered the load in North Dakota, and then that's when the dispatcher calls me up and says, "Hey, Alex, I got a load for you. It's an interesting one. Tell me how you feel about it." And when your dispatcher says something like that, it means a lot of deadhead. obviously I'm just kidding, but here's the load. It's Moorhead, Minnesota to Bodle, South Dakota. I believe that's how, it was like two pallets basically. And it was like super hot. And we told them the dispatcher told them, I guess would be the correct way. He's like, hey, we have something on the front of the trailer, but this will fit on the back. Are you okay with that? And they're like, okay, fine. And they're paying, as you can see right here, $1,000, right? On like 200 something miles. Here you go. I have it routed right here. So from Tioga to Moorhead, Minnesota to Bowdle, South Dakota, it's $595. But on the loaded miles, if you do Moorhead to Bodle, I guess, it's 242 miles. So they're paying $1,000 on 242 miles, so it's a really, it was a solid load. And I don't have any footage of it. I literally just put it on the trailer and took off because they needed it really bad. So all I have is this picture right here. So obviously, as you can see, it's just two pallets, nothing crazy, nothing out of the ordinary, just a quick, simple load. And 5 hours later, I literally delivered it and I put $1,000 in my pocket. Well, not really, it wasn't COD. It was still needed to be factored, but whatever, you know what I mean? You get the point. That basically those 5 hours, I put $1,000 in my pocket. But here's the problem. From there, I then started going to McGee, Arkansas, which is where that plow was going, right? And so I started driving down there, and we couldn't find anything else along the way, nothing worthwhile. So it was kind of ridiculous. So I want to crunch the numbers, what it was to go north and then come back down to Arkansas, because from there I had another really good trip. So I'll crunch those in a second. But let's crunch the total rate per mile for this, all these loads so far. All right, so here's all the miles: Louisville, Rome, Sioux Falls, Combe, Tioga, Moorhead, Bowdle, and McGee, right? That's all the locations. So total mileage is 3,191. And the total revenue, if you recall, it was 2,500 for the platforms, 1,500, then 1,625, and then the $1,000 load. So that gives us a total of $6,625 on 3,191 miles. And when you do the math, believe it or not, it's $2.07 a mile, or like $2.07 and some change. You could round up, call it 208, or round down, whatever you want to do. But still, $2.07, and I ended up in Arkansas, which wasn't super awesome because my next load, I did deadhead to Louisiana to pick it up. But here's the problem. I'm recording this all like in one day, but I just came back from the haircut. That's why, obviously you understand. But anyways, let's continue to the next trip. Now, here's the problem with when you guys ask for vlogs, right? The issue is sometimes I just get in the working mood and I'm like, well, I don't want to record this easy load, or like there's no problems. And contrary to what you guys might see on the channel, believe it or not, I do actually do a lot of loads without any problems, like no damages, no breakdowns, no issues. And so I know you guys ask for vlogs, but it's hard for me to give that to you when I'm delivering 95% of my loads no problems, because then I only upload the stuff that's interesting. And more than likely what you're asking for is interesting vlogs, not just a regular vlog. But anyways, that's enough of that. Let's jump into this load where I went to the Northeast. It was four partials. Let me get these, let me tell you about all these loads. We'll be right back. All right, so the first load I booked, so to my northeast, or you know, to the northeast region, I wanted something longer, you know, like over the weekend. So the first load was these steel plates, and the reason I booked them, guys, okay, now here's a super good tip, is whenever you see steel plates, whenever it's like, you know, 7 feet wide or 8 feet wide and like, you know, 3, 5, 6 inches tall and like a couple thousand pounds, remember that sometimes you can put a load on top of that, just as long as that's okay with the broker and the customer, where, you know, with your delivery order, all that stuff. So the reason I booked this is like literally because of that. It's like 2,000 pounds. I'm like, dude, really, I could fit anything else with that. So worst case scenario, it'll be a super aerodynamic load if I can't stack anything on top. But if I can, then it'll be a super profitable run. So win-win either way. And so that's why I booked this load, and we loaded up Baker, Louisiana, right? And so here's the demand. Here it is, right? So this was the 20 feet, roughly 7 feet. Look at what the broker put: 7 feet, 1 inch wide, 1 foot, 1 inch tall. And as you can see in the video, clearly those two pieces aren't like that. They're like 2 feet wide, maybe max. And they were going from Baker, Louisiana to Clifton, New Jersey. And then right here, $1,831.32. That was the actual rate, which is ridiculous. So that's this first load. Now, while I'm sitting in Baker, Louisiana at that shipper, the dispatcher calls me up and says, Alex, you won't believe it. There is another load from Baker, Louisiana, from that location, going to Maryland, right? And I'm excited. I'm like, oh, this is amazing, right? This is gonna be a great run. It's also a couple thousand pounds, some pipes, and we book it, right? I tell the dispatcher, I'm like, book it, grab it, that's awesome. So the broker ends up giving us the load and we get the paperwork, but the problem is that shipper didn't have that load ready. And so what ended up happening is we asked the broker if he could give us a layover charge, which they did. So we got an extra $150 layover charge, but I booked a forklift that was coming from Mississippi. So I actually went to Mississippi, picked up the forklift, and then went back to Baker, Louisiana and picked up the pipes the next day. But wait, there's more. So what ends up happening is I see that I have some more room left over and some more weight. And sure enough, I find like this tank, fiberglass tank. It was like several hundred pounds. And I ended up grabbing the fiberglass tank. No loading footage of any of these loads. I do have a bunch of unload footage to show you though. So stay tuned for that. And then I'll do the cost per mile on this one, because this was a really rare good trip like that. But still, so I grabbed this fiberglass tank, loaded up. Honestly, with how much it ruined the MPG, I think it might have been a mistake, but whatever. I guess something is better than nothing, right? All right, so let's crunch the numbers about this rate, about the super good rate, right? I mean, four partials, we're talking four picks, four drop. But anyway, so Baker, Louisiana to Clifton, New Jersey, 1831. Then we got Bay Springs, Mississippi. That's that forklift to a forklift to Albany, New York. Right here, you can see 1900. And then we got right here the pipe and the flat bar that I went back to Baker, Louisiana to Baltimore, Maryland. And there with the layover right here, 150. So 1950 for that one. And then the last thing, like I said, is this tank for $1,000 right there. So yeah, 1,048 miles. So that's Suwanee, Georgia to North Waltham, Massachusetts, and that's how you say that. So anyways, that means right here. So here it is, McGee, Arkansas, which is where we unloaded to Baker, to Bay Springs, to Baker, to Suwanee, to, right? So you can see all these ones right here on the side. Like obviously it's a lot, but total mileage is 2,313 miles. Can you see that right there? So 2313, and the total revenue was $6,681 gross. So really, really good. And you know, when you do the rate per mile, it's 288 per mile. So that's a very, very solid rate per mile for a 40-foot hotshot. But this is also why you get a 40-footer, you know, because that last remaining 8 to 10 feet of the deck is a super, super crucial one. Because if I had, for example, a 36, that means instead of having that 11 feet left over, I would only have 7. And it's like, well, 7 foot partials usually pay like $600, and there's 400, 500, 600 bucks. So it's usually not even worth wasting your time on, right? Because then you lose a whole day for that drop or something like that. So really, you know, I want to say like it's a rare rate. It is, you know, really good. And keep in mind, this is also a couple weeks old now. You know, this obviously, when I did my video when I was sitting in Maryland, that was when I was delivering this load, right? So it's definitely been a few weeks since then. right, so now I'm in the upper northeast and I have to deadhead, so I deadhead back to PA where the dispatcher booked me this load. It was two pallets with this like one little tube over here, and that was paying $1,500. And then we partnered that up with another load of, a load of pipes that was going, and all these things, both of these are going to California. So this is the long haul that I've been waiting for, so that's pretty cool. And so I drove a lot, like this was the long haul like I wanted. You know, sometimes it's nice to have just where you're just driving, not doing all these picks and drops, because the picks and drops are really time consuming and you're always going, you know, whereas you sometimes you just wake up and drive 600-700 miles a day. So it's like, you know, there's pros and cons to both, I guess you could say. But anyways, I, you know, absolutely no problems in picking up, delivering. Only those two pallets needed tarp, so that was pretty good. And I got all of those unloaded fairly quickly, as quick as I could, obviously. So then from California, the dispatcher was able to find the final load back to Kansas. So from Cali to Kansas, and from Kansas, I deadheaded home back to Texas. Okay. All right. So this was the first load right here. You can see Bethlehem, Pennsylvania to Pomona, California. And then you can see right there, $1,500, and it did need a tarp, as you can see, but it was only 700 pounds and it was pretty low. So nothing too crazy with that first partial. The second load was right here, $4,175 for the rate. And that was the Alum Bank, Pennsylvania to Lakeside, California, right? And then here's the load, Gardena, California to Wichita, Kansas. And that was the $2,450 right there. You can see that. So three decent loads. You know, you might be wondering, Alice, what's the rate per mile on that? So here you go. Here's the North Waltham where we delivered to Bethlehem. It came up as Pleasantville, but that's like roughly around there. Lakeside, Pomona, Gardena, and Wichita, right? That's exactly how I delivered it. And so you can see 45.25 on the miles, and we got 81.25 on the revenue, which is good revenue. And then of course we got $1.79 on the rate per mile. You know, that doesn't include the deadhead back to Texas. So, you know, it was probably lower than that after all things considered, but really for, you know, just three simple loads, really nothing out of the ordinary, not a bad rate per mile for sure. So yeah, $1.79. Pair that up with the $2.88 that I came up to the Northeast for, and really, I think we're all things considered, it's like $2.20 around there. So really, really not bad at all. All right, well, that's gonna do it for this video. I realize this video started out as a vlog type of video, and then it just became a like knowledge, like rate per mile, like here, check out the route, what I did, a video, but like educational basically. But you know, right now I got these two, they just woke up, so no more YouTubing for Alex, time to be a father. So that'll do it for this one. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.